trial closes will help you know if the time is right to close the sale. But until you get the client to sign, you've got no sale. Getting the signature is where many ad reps freeze up.
So you like the ad then?
Oh, why, yes, I love it.
And the budget is okay?
Oh, the budget's fine. Finer than frog's hair.
And you could handle using the extra clients?
Oh, honey, yes, indeedy. I need customers.
Oh, great. So any objections to getting started then?
Well, no. No, not at all.
Okay. I should give you some time to think about this and I can come back tomorrow.
Are you out of your mind?
Well, I wasn't sure she was ready.
Honey, I'm as ready as they get.
You must take charge and write up the order. Show your confidence. Do it.
Okay. Let me get out my insertion order and contract.
Oh, sure thing.
Now that you're at the close, keep in mind that the advertiser is in a vulnerable emotional position. Whether they've actually said it or not, they have agreed to buy something and they may be nervous. Ease them through the situation by using non-threatening words and body language. Watch the difference in these two closings.
Great to have you on board, Mr. Rafter. Our policy is to insist that we have $120 payment for the first ad up front. No exceptions or exclusions. You must sign the contract, you must fill out our credit application, and with credit approval, we will bill you. Do you understand each of these terms and conditions as I have so stated?
I think I'll let my attorney look these over before I sign any contract. Come back next week and I'll let you know.
Now, listen to the language used in more non-threatening speech.
I'm certain that we're going to make money for you, Mr. Rafter. I'll leave a credit application with your bookkeeper and we can get you a monthly billing. And I will need a check for $120, but it's just for the first ad only. I just need to okay the paperwork here and we can go ahead and get started.
Oh, no problem. I'll have Bev cut you a check.
Using non-threatening words like initial the paperwork instead of sign the contract, or pronouns like we will get you credit instead of you must fill out our credit application are much more effective. Body language is an important part of closing with conviction. You want to make certain your nonverbal signs all point that you're confident in your proposal and yourself. Now watch what happens when the nonverbal body language signals don't match what's said.
Mr. Plunger, I feel certain that an ad in the Blattsburg Bugle will deliver the new business you need. Your $1,000 will not be wasted. I've taken the liberty of reserving you an insertion in our Sunday edition, effective on the 15th. So what do you say, Mr. Plunger? Are we in or not? Yes? No? Maybe?
We've got a little clog in our pipes here, Missy. We're gonna have to pass.
Instead, opt for more confident, professional body language. Lean into the advertiser. Use direct, friendly eye contact. And mirror the client. That is, use roughly the same postures and vocal styles as the client. Friendly, yet confident.
Mr. Plunger, we need to start this Sunday. I've already started the paperwork to help you get those new customers you need.
Yep, I can see that.
Great, let me finish up the paperwork then. Would you like the invoice sent here or to your P.O. box?
Confidence, both in voice and body language, is powerful. When you get the paperwork filled out, it's time to get a signature. And this is the time to be a true professional.
Okay, Mrs. Dingle, I just need you to initial this paperwork and we can get started.
Let me look this over.
If the price is too high, I can discount it or make the ad smaller.
No. Once you put the pen in front of the client, say nothing. The person who speaks first loses. Show your conviction. Sit quietly as long as it takes, but don't assume there's a problem. If the client has an objection, let them bring it up. Now let's try again.
Okay, Mrs. Dingle, I just need you to initial this paperwork and we can get started.
Let me look this over.
Effective closing starts with having a strong client-centered presentation, integrating the advertiser's information with your newspaper's benefits. Then, it's a matter of the power of your conviction, your sincere belief that the advertiser must advertise with you. Closing with conviction comes from within you. It's your sincere belief that you can help your advertiser's business grow by giving them access to your readers. Remember, you can only help your advertiser's business by getting them in the newspaper. So do it.